Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Elegant Corner. In this video we'll discuss about the resume, what are the things we need to incorporate in the resume. One of our subscribers texted me personally to do the video upon the resume, what are the things to incorporate in the resume. This video is only for the freshers who has completed their education and starting their career for applying for any job and all. So we'll discuss about the resume, what are the things you need to incorporate in the resume. Before starting the video, if you are new to the channel, please do subscribe my channel Elegant Corner, and you will get you just click the bell icon, you will get the notification whenever I do the video. Now we'll go to the video. See, before going to the things to incorporate in the resume, you need to have a clear cut view what is meant by a resume. Resume is nothing but like a menu. It is like a menu of yourself. What are the things like skills or background of yourself, representing in a simple format, so that if anyone refers your resume, so he will get an idea of yourself, on yourself, regarding various aspects like educational qualifications, academic details and all. So this is, resume is nothing but a simplified format of yourself, your background, to represent each and everything in a particular sessions. So nowadays each and everyone was getting confusion who are being a fresher. So because in the internet we are having lots of formats and lots of styles of resumes. See, whatever the style or whatever the formats, you need to represent a few 7 points which we are displaying here. These 7 points are very mandatory and very important things to be incorporated in the resume. We'll discuss one by one what are the points, what these points were representing, what are the things you need to incorporate in these points and all. We'll start with the career objective. The first foremost thing is the career objective. Career objective is nothing but what is your main motto, what is the thing in your brain to what is your motto, what is your representation. So the career objective need to be simplified way, and it need to be clear cut what are the things which was present in your mind. See, few people just copy paste from the internet and all like career objective, it is not that correct. Because if you represent the thing which was present in our brain, so that the people who were reading our resume will have an idea, okay, this X person have this career objective, so he was applying for this job, his motto, his plan, okay, this is his career objective, he will get an idea. Then comes with an educational qualification, the second foremost point. Here in the educational qualification, you need to represent all the things from your schooling to the up to your highest degree, like year of passing, like name of the educational institute, what is the percentage, these kind of information you need to represent in the educational qualification. Then comes with the academic achievements. For example, in this session, if you got any achievements in your academics while you are studying, like if you got any gold medal, or if you got any, you are the topper, if you get any certificates regarding this kind of things in the academics, then you need to represent in the like in the academic achievements. This is all about the technical aspect only. Related to the educational point of view, you need to represent all the academic achievements you have acquired while being a student. Then comes with the project details. Here, whatever the degree may be, whether it may be BTech, MTech or MBA, whatever may be, you used to do mini project internships and like final projects. You need to give the details of the projects, whatever the projects you have carried out being a student, and you need to give like one or two lines of summary of the project, so that the individual who was referring your resume will get an idea, okay, this X person was have the interest upon this topic, so he has a grip upon this area, so he has done the he has done the project upon this particular things. So by reading two or three lines, he will get an idea about what are the projects you have, what are the internships or what are the mini projects you have done in your educational level and all. Then comes with the skills acquired. These skills are acquired relating to the technical point of view. See, we should not confuse to the third point and this fifth point. See, the third point is about the academic achievements while being the student. Whatever the achievements, like gold medals, or if you are the topper, or if you are an candidate of with the good skills and all, there you will get a separate certificates. This is all about the skills you have acquired by being a student, like technical skills, Like for example, if you know any languages like C languages, C++, Java, Oracle, or if you are well versed with any softwares, whether it may be AutoCAD, STAT Pro, like design softwares, like R programming in the MBA, these kind of things you need to incorporate in the session of skills acquired technically. Then comes with the extracurricular activities. Up to this mark, we have discussed all the things which were related to the educational point of view. But coming to this sixth point, extracurricular activities, being an individual, we have some skills in ourselves, like with our own desire, like some few people are interested in singing, few people are interested in drawing, few people are interested in dancing, and they used to be participated in the educational level while they are in the schooling, in any functions and all, they used to get participation certificates. Not only in the this kind of things, whether if they are participating in any games like football, volleyball, any tournaments and all, they used to get like prize winning, award winning, or participation certificates and all. These kind of things you need to incorporate in the extracurricular activities. Or if you organize any events, being a student in your college level or school level, that participation certificate also you can incorporate in this sixth point. Coming to the last seventh point, one of the foremost important thing, like personal details, you need to give few personal details about yourself, like your name, your father's name, your hometown, you are from where, which place, like whatever the languages you have known, etc. Like these few aspects you need to represent. See, these are the basic seven points you need to incorporate in the resume. You can see all these points upon the screen. So being a fresher, you need to incorporate all these seven points mandatory in your resume in a clear cut, simple way, so that the individual who was referring your resume will get an idea upon the things, what is your background. Okay, like this resume is a simplified way of your menu, like the things which were incorporated in yourself, you are representing upon the paper and you are giving the resume for any job application. So if you have any doubts, you can text me personally or you can text in the comment box below. So I will read each and every comment and I will do the videos upon your liking and upon your doubts which on particular aspects. If you like this video, please like it, and if please subscribe my channel and share to your friends, and we'll continue the further topics in the coming video. And signing off, your Sai.